Let me start sharing my slides here. So I would like you also to participate in this discussion because this is something you people are going to face it more because we have taken the responsibility. We as a generation, I'm including you also in that because you are also young. You are also seeing that if we do something today for our future generation, then only our future generation will be able to see and live the way we have been able to. Though we are living in a place where there is a lot of technological advancement, but at the same time, a lot of deterioration as far as the environment and ecology is concerned. All right. So I have another video that I have to play for you. But guys, just wait for some time. I want to talk about that. One second. Yes, we were here. All right. So is the slide visible to you now?
No.
Is it not visible? Oh, okay, fine. Thank you. One second. Just give me one moment because I have to again change into the Wacom tablet so that I can write for you. So, this is one more video that I want you to see. But before that, I will... We did talk on this also. So here is the, gist of that speech that was given at the Climate Action Summit. Okay. So with the global emissions reaching record levels high and showing no signs of peaking. Let me change the color. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres called on all the leaders to come to New York on 23rd September 2019 for the Climate Action Summit. So whatever video that you saw just before this meeting started, it was excerpt from this summit, okay? And his speech. With concrete realistic plans to enhance their nationality determined by the contribution by 2020. In line with the reducing greenhouse gas emission by 45% over the next decade. That means you can imagine how much emphasis is laid now on green energy. That means that is why there you must have seen that in the news Tesla cars are gaining more mileage because they are shifting from the petrol and petroleum products to electricity as well as other modes of fuel consumption. Okay, and this is going to be the new technology because we want to reduce the emission, greenhouse gas emission by 45%. It's not a small figure. It's drastically amount as close as 50%. Whatever we are right now currently emitting, it has to reduce. It has still not been achieved because of the corona pandemic that struck in between. And because, we did not take care, nature took care of itself by having that corona pandemic. So you can also say that it was interference by God. So when the corona pandemic hit our earth globally, most of the vehicles, everything came to a standstill for a year or so, isn't it? So when everything was in standstill, definitely 45% could have been, I think more was achieved during that time. But still we need to, now the third wave is coming, Omicron virus variant has already hit. So I don't know for how long it is going to be since we were not taking enough steps. I put it this way always because as a human being, we were not taking enough steps. So nature had to intervene. Nature intervened in the form of pandemic. And which pandemic? Corona, COVID-19. All right. So moving forward, Let me show you this video first. It's a very small video. It's not a very big one, but I loved it because it gives you the whole gist of the story. Okay. One second again, I'll have to put the mouse and remove the Wacom tablet. This becomes very tedious work for me, you know. When I work on a desktop, it is easy, but on a laptop, we don't have so many ports here. So anyways, give me one second, you'll just bear with me. Any delays? I need to copy this link and okay. So I will be presenting you this video. It's a very, very cute video. You must have seen it also before. One second. I don't know what has happened. All right, just anybody can, one of you can unmute and tell me whether it is visible or not.
Yes, not visible.
My job is to make college easier because students have a lot of fun.
So this was a very small video. Just a trailer. Okay, so I'm going to again present my slide to you. So I was here. All right, so moving forward, IPCC report. What does it say? IPCC climate report. What is IPCC? It is basically Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. All right. So what does it say? Again, one second. I was trying to write, but then mouse was already fixed here in the port. And okay. So what does it say? It says that global warming to up to 1.5 degrees centigrade. If we have to limit it to this increase, otherwise it is increasing day by day. And as Antonio Guterres said in that video, if you have heard it very clearly, that by the end of this century, it is going to rise up to 3 degrees centigrade, which means drastic changes going to happen in the world environment. All right, so if we have to limit it to this, to 1.5 degree, it would require rapid, far-reaching, unprecedented changes in all aspects of society, as per the IPCC. Okay, so with clear benefit to people and natural ecosystem, we need to limit the global warming to 1.5 degree centigrade. Compared to the 2 degree centigrade, could go hand in hand with ensuring more sustainable and equitable society. But since it is going beyond this, so we need to keep a check on it. Otherwise, it's really going to, the danger is going to come before what it is predicted. Okay, now this is one important picture that I have taken from the net, and it says there are 9 tipping points where we need to work on. 9 tipping points, you see, where changing climate could push parts of Earth system into abrupt or irreversible changes. So what are those 9 tipping points? This is permafrost. This one, Atlantic meridional overturning circulation breakdown. Then boreal forest shift. Then we have West Antarctic sheet disintegration. Then Amazon rainforest die back. Then West African monsoon shift, Indian monsoon shift, and few more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Which is the fourth one? Ha! Coral reef die off. Okay? So how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One is still missing. Where is that? I don't know. Could be. Can anybody help me find out the ninth one? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So anyways, we'll start. Maybe we'll be able to find locate it. Okay. So permafrost basically abrupt increase in the emission of carbon dioxide and methane through the thawing frozen carbon rich soil. Thawing means when something starts melting. So there is always an increase in the level of carbon dioxide. जब भी हम लोग फ्रिज में से कोई खाना निकालते हैं ना, you remember? फ्रिज में से जैसे खाना निकालते हैं and we keep it for some 10 to 15 minutes, right? So that it becomes thaw, comes to the normal temperature. That means एकदम frozen state से it comes to the melted stage. So that is called thawing. So that is called permafrost loss. And why is it happening? Because of the global warming. Now, Atlantic meridional overturning circulation breakthrough. So this is Atlantic Ocean. So this permafrost is happening in which region? You can see clearly it is in the Arctic region. It is the Arctic region of the world. And then this is the Atlantic between United States and Europe. So what is happening over there? It is basically shutdown of the AMOC caused by increased influx of fresh water into the North Atlantic. So what are the impacts? Regional cooling, disruption to ecosystem, etc. So it is permafrost is happening due to greenhouse release. Now third is boreal forest shift. So this green color, that means here in Siberia, and here it is in the northern of North Canada. Alright. So a shift in the boreal forest, seeing expansion of tundra to the north and die back to the south. Alright. Now what is it? It is basically an ecological shift or because of regional warming. So we did talk about three. So whatever is in green, it is a biome shift. Whatever is in blue, it is because of the melting of ice. Is that clear? So here also, this is Brazil, because Brazil is the only country which has got maximum of the Amazon rainforest. All right, so Amazon rainforest die back. It is because of the deforestation and hotter, drier condition causing dieback of the rainforest and shift towards savanna. So they are moving. Now biodiversity is lost because of this shift, and there is a decrease in the rainfall. As I told you, there are wildfires that are happening because of decrease in the rainfall in the equatorial region. So this region is equatorial region basically. So sorry. This is not the equatorial. Equatorial is around here. Okay. This is 0 degree equator. So the sunlight is totally at 90 degree here. And because of the high sunlight, the moisture in the surrounding sea, it gets evaporated. And because of lot of moisture, there is always a rain in the day. Means every day there is a rain, no matter what. That means 365 days, this region they experience rain, and because of excess rain plus humidity, the rainforest they flourishes. But now they are saying there is a shift in that thing, and less of the rainfall is resulting in because of the climate change, and because of the less rain, the wildfires are happening. Is that clear? Now, West Antarctic ice sheet disintegration. Now, NASA has seen that when it has taken photograph of Earth from the South Pole, around 30 years back by NASA, the Antarctic was very big. Okay, now when it is taken, recent photograph shows that the Antarctic, it has reduced. Okay, and especially in the western side, that means below South America continent. So there is a sheet disintegration, collapse of ice sheet. So what do you think will happen because of that? Definitely ice is melting, so that means water level will rise. You can imagine water level if here rises, all those cities who are here and also here, because water is such a thing that it will find its own way. So wherever there is less water, it will just immediately shift. So most of the coastal cities, they will drown, they will get submerged up to 3 meters. You can imagine sea level will rise up to 3 meters. Collapse of ice sheet triggered by the persistent grounding line retreat in one sector cascading to the other sector. All right, now we come to Sahara. This is Sahara Desert. I'll change the color so that it becomes easy for you to make it out. All right, we'll take this green color. So here, Western African monsoon shift. An abrupt change in the Sahel rainfall caused by a shift northward to a south or southward in the West African mountain. Why? Disruption to agriculture and ecosystem is changed because of this change. And all these things are happening because of the climate change, because we are not taking care. We are just, living our life as if there is no tomorrow. We are not thinking of our future generation. The amount of damage that we have done in the past 200 years is such drastic damage that Earth is going to collapse in another 100 year or so because of whatever we have done in the past 200 years. And we are still not learning any lessons from it. Okay. Now, Indian monsoon shift. So since we are living in India, so we can understand that yes, monsoon shift is there. You must be wondering now why the rains are, shifting towards October, till October end we are getting the rains. Earlier it used to end by September, isn't it? So, strengthening of the monsoon caused by rising carbon dioxide emission or a weakening as a result of the aerosol emission. So, all these things are man-made. Disruption to agriculture, greater rainfall extremes, all right? I think there. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So anyways, now, wherever there are coral reefs, coral reefs are present in this area, okay? And some very little extent here in this area between Egypt and the Middle East countries and also in the West Indies island. So 1, 2, and 3. Let me change the color so that you can get it. 1, 2, and these are the major coral reefs of the world. But they are dying off. Why they are dying off? Because of the rising temperature and they are getting bleached. As you must have heard his speech, Antonio Guterres, he said coral reefs bleaching. Coral reefs, when you see from up, they are basically very brightly colored reefs underwater. So when they are bleaching, that means they are losing the colors. That means they are dying off. All right. Next is, I think I've covered all these 8 points that I can see. I think 9th point is somewhere missing. Maybe when I was taking a screenshot, maybe somewhere here I missed it. I had cut that point. Anyways, I'll get back to that and show you some other day. All right. Now, Moving forward, I hope you have understood what are the 9 major tipping points and what you and General Secretary General was telling about all these 9 things. All right. Now, what are the signs of climate change? These are the, in a nutshell, we can say high temperature, changing rain and snow patterns, more droughts, warmer oceans, rising sea levels, wilder weather, increasing of ocean acidity, as I explained to you, and shrinking sea ice. So these are the major signs of climate change. All right. Now, you know what is Rocca agriculture? As I was telling you, suppose this is South America, somewhat like this. Huh? It is like this. So this is South America. Here we have Amazon rainforest. So now this rainforest is also called lungs of the world. Why they are called lungs of the world? Because this rainforest on its own, they produces lot of oxygen that can be consumed by whole of the world. They are called lungs of the world because they are so dense. They are full packed with leaves and, you know, lot of greeneries. And what do they produce? Whenever the trees are there, they produce lot of oxygen. So world's 60% need of oxygen is supplied through this world Amazon rainforest. But because of certain agricultural practices, what is happening? That we are destroying this rainforest. Rocca agriculture may we use shifting agriculture. Okay, that means it involves clearing of the forest, burning the stubble, and cultivating the land for few years before moving to another plot. Because people there, they don't realize ki what is the importance of these Amazon rainforests. They don't know that they are called the lungs of the world. Because they are destroying, they think they are doing very small, you know, patch of land they are destroying and then use it for agriculture. Then they leave this area for, getting all right up for few days. They leave this area so that it can, you know, it can regenerate itself and they move to another place. So in this regard, what they are doing is basically harming the Amazon rainforest. And because of this, there is a shift and there is less rains that is happening. And because of the less rain, what is happening? Wildfires are catching on everywhere. So, see, everything is interrelated. As you see, if we change one thing, we can stop the other thing from happening. Now, you want to see how it is? This is how they do it. They burn this area so that, you know, they can practice agriculture for some few, 2-3 years. And then they leave this area so that it can regenerate itself and again the forest can come and they go to another piece of land. This is how they do it. Alright. Now, similar way in India also, in many countries, actually these types of practices, they happen everywhere. Okay. In India, we have jhoom agriculture. What is jhoom agriculture? It is also a traditional farming method where the first land of trees and other vegetation is cleared. So basically everywhere we have this habit of clearing things, they are burned and then cultivated for a limited number of years. Now jhoom cultivation is also known as shifting cultivation. Jaise ki Rocca tha na, Rocca is also a shifting cultivation. It is called in Brazilian language, it is called Rocca, and in India it is called jhoom. Okay, so and a slash and a burns cultivation, it is one of the oldest system of cultivation. But now we have to put a stop to this because you know what, it is harming our environment. You want to see? I have kept a photograph of this, how the trees are cut and then they are, you know, made prepared for cultivation, and after cultivation they are left just like that. And you know, it takes long years to, you know, rejuvenate this area again. Cutting trees will only take, you know, 5 to 6 months to clear this much of land. Even not that, even 1 month may you can cut all this area. But to get back to this green state, it takes years, many years to come back to the state. So all these things are hampering the climate. All right. So this, with this, I finish my climate wala chapter.